Today we have Dr. Otero with us. Hello, Dr. Otero. How are
Hey, good
you?
morning, Michelle. Doing well. How
Good
are
morning.
you
I'm good. I'm good. So what we're doing today is we are going to go through a phone call that you would go through if you're having trouble fitting your easy denture. And we're
Yeah.
just going to show you what that is like. I am calling Dr. Otero because I'm very frustrated about fitting these. I'm having a hard time. So can you help me, Dr. Otero?
Okay, so oftentimes when we have patients that are having issues fitting their easy denture, it's a rare occurrence, but on occasion people have gone through and they're like, hey, I've tried trimming, I've tried this, I've tried that, it's just not fitting just right, walk me through it. What we asked for initially is I just asked the patients to send me a few pictures. I was like, okay, send me some pictures of the inside of the denture. And they'll just take those photos with their cell phone and they'll text it over or email it over. And we're able to look to see, what are the issues with the denture. Sometimes patients just aren't pushing it in enough, and we could see that in the picture. You could tell how much displaced material has had, how much of the material has been displaced. If patients aren't putting enough pressure, they're not heating it enough to get it in place, or if they just have, or if they've taken away too much material and they need to add some back, and we, kind of walk them through that. So that's the process that we go through there. And then if we have to get on a video call, we could do that as well, similar to what we're doing here, Michelle.
Okay, so I need to go heat up some water because you need that, right?
Yes, correct.
So
So
while
sometimes it just comes down to simple following the instructions. Did you boil the water? Because it needs boiling water. The water needs to be hot in order to activate our thermoplastic. And that's the beauty of easy denture. It's not something that's going to start getting soft when you're drinking hot coffee. That's not going to happen. It has to sit in that boiling water for at least 15 to 20 seconds for it to just even start getting soft.
Okay, I'm gonna go get my water ready. And while I do that, can you tell us what kind of teeth are on these dentures?
Sure, absolutely. I'll put you out there. Thanks, Michelle. So we use a high impact denture resin. So our denture teeth and easy denture is made with the same materials that your high-end dentures are going to be made with. Only we formulated them to be thermoplastic, so it's able to shift and form whenever you need it to adjust to your mouth. So it becomes flexible so they could adjust to how your bite is, whether you're because oftentimes patients are only missing the lower teeth or only missing their upper teeth. So we needed easy dentures occlusion to be able to shift and adjust to what it's going to be chewing against. So when you get your denture initially, your easy denture initially, and you're looking at it, don't worry about the plane of occlusion, what that's looking like, because that's going to change when you put it in hot water and manipulate it and get it to size to your mouth. Made out of a high impact denture resin, some of the strongest denture teeth out there.
Okay, I've got it in my hot Pyrex bowl here.
All right. So you have your boiling water there, your hot water. You're going to put the denture. Typically, I like to start with the upper for the patients. I have some patients that like to start with the lower, but typically we start with the upper and we get that lined up first. So you're
Okay.
going to take the upper denture and we're going to drop it in the hot water. I like to do it teeth down.
Teeth down. I'm gonna use a spoon because this is really odd.
Perfect, perfect. Sounds good to avoid some of the
Okay.
splashes. And I like the teeth down because our NuvaFlex stretch material, the real thermoplastic that stretches and you're able to take off and change around, that gets pretty sticky when it gets really hot. So it just makes it easier to remove the denture from the boiling water when you put it teeth down. And Michelle has a slotted spoon there. You can use that. I like to use tongs. Tongs are pretty simple as well. We're going to leave it in the boiling water for a minute.
Okay.
So what that's doing is it's basically activating the material, the thermoplastic. So it's getting it nice and soft in there, and then you'll see almost it starts to get a little bit clear on top there as it starts to heat up, which is nice. But you want to, so the way Michelle has done it here is right. If you have access to a stovetop, perfect. You want that water boiling. If you have access to a microwave, great. You could go ahead and boil the water in the microwave first, but I do not want the easy denture going into the microwave, and I'll tell you why. So when you have boiling water, you have a maximum temperature of 212 degrees. That's where boiling water is going to stop. It's not going to get any hotter than that when you have that boil. So that's where we're keeping our safety factor too. That way we know that once the easy denture has been in boiling water, for 60 seconds, it's going to start cooling from that temperature. It's never going to get any hotter than 212 degrees. We want to be careful not to get anything too hot because I don't want anyone to burn themselves. So following these instructions, you'll prevent, you know, any burns there, anything getting too hot. So we definitely want to start with that 212 degree or below point. So do not ever put your Easy Denture in the microwave. Do not put it in the pot in the microwave either. You know, the hot water could come out of the microwave, that's fine. And then you can put your Easy Denture in there, or boiling water on a cooktop as well. You know, since it's in that water, it's not going to get above 212 degrees.
Okay. You think we're about ready to come out? I think so.
It's been close to a minute there. So.
All right. So what are we going to do with it now?
And then just go ahead and we remove it from the boiling water. And we place it face down on the counter, teeth down on the countertop. Perfect. Just like that. And then we want to let it cool for about a minute. And you can touch it after about 30 seconds and feel it out. And if it feels comfortable and cool enough to your hands, it's going to be fine to go ahead and start adapting and placing in your mouth.
I think I'm all right with this.
Okay. So you're going to feels sticky, it feels fine to the back of your hand, right? When you stick it to the back of your hand, it's not too hot?
No.
Okay, perfect. Sounds good. So now you'll put it in your mouth.
Uh-huh.
You want to size it up. You want to adapt the palate of your mouth. I kind of like doing like a little thumb sucking, and I like it when my patients push around their cheeks here on the outside too, because that helps to manipulate. Once you line the teeth up in the middle, you know, look in the mirror, make sure the teeth are looking center there, and yours are looking pretty close there.
Yeah.
Okay. And then just kind of adapt around here, run your thumb around the roof of your mouth, do a little like literal thumb sucking, like. And that helps to get a little bit of a posterior seal, get the seal around the back, and adapt the material up around their vestibules to make sure you get that fit.
Okay.
What we're doing is basically, with the Easy Denture, it's almost taking like an impression of the inside of your mouth because that material really flows and adapts around.
Okay. I think I'm happy with that.
I feel okay there. Mm-hmm. So I like to keep it in place just for about 30 seconds to a minute, let it start to harden up a little bit. And then I have patients we have customers that end up having a lot of tori or bony extrusions in the mouth. So for those, you do want to start getting the denture out early when it's still soft to make sure it doesn't harden in your mouth. So you want to kind of take it out, then you can put it back in and good. Sounds like you got a little suction there.
I did. Look at that.
And then you see how the inside, you see how it molded to everything there nicely? That adapted really well, Michelle. Nice job.
Thank you.
All right. So now what we could do is we can cool it down, or we could heat it again if it doesn't feel like it fit well. You see, you have some extensions around the back, around the palate. Looks like it went a little long there.
It did.
So if that's an area that you want to heat up again and trim off with some scissors, you can just literally kind of put that back end right back in the hot water, just the back end only. Yep. You can do it just like that. If you want to, you could use tongs or use a spoon. And then once that's soft, it should take only about 15 or 20 seconds there to do that. Once that area is soft, you could just trim it right off pretty easily. Don't worry, if you trim too much off, you could add it back if you need to. If you want to put that back in your mouth and adapt and see how that feels.
Up, coming up. That feels much better.
Okay, so it's not gagging you as much there.
Uh-uh.
So when you get that, we add a lot of material in there so patients can have plenty to remove if they need to. I'd rather you have excess material, like too much, than too little. So we did that on purpose in the design of the Easy Denture.
Can I take it out?
Yes. You can take it out now. I just wanted to kind of reform that back area and make sure it feels good.
All right. That feels much better.
Okay. Looks good there. So now you can run it under cool water if you want to, and in your tap is just fine. And that just helps to set it. So now it's no longer in that phase, in that thermoplastic phase where we're going to get any adaptation changes. And then once it's set, you really have to put it back in that boiling water for at least 15 to 20 seconds before you get any changes again. So don't worry about the thermoplastic properties at this point whenever you're eating hot foods or drinking anything hot. You're never going to have anything in your mouth hot enough to cause that to deform.
I can, it's changing back to a lighter color now.
Yeah, so once it's back to that normal color, that it's kind of out of that that thermoplastic phase.
All right, now what should we do? What's next? We want to do the bottom denture?
So now we'll do the bottom denture. So you'll put the upper denture back in place, and you want the upper denture in your mouth, and you can use a little adhesive right now to keep it in place. I recommend that for all customers, for everyone that wears a denture. I'm a big adhesive fan. I think it's great on, you know, keeping any food particles out. It just works really well.
I am also a big adhesive fan, even though sometimes I don't need it, mm-hmm. I'll still use it. Yeah. So where would you suggest that I put this adhesive?
All right, so I like to follow the rules. What Procter & Gamble has set up with their Fixident product. They like to do a nice little, almost a triangle on the palatal portion of the denture.
Now, what about if you just had extractions? Should you use the adhesive?
I still use adhesive with extractions, but only in the palatal portion, not in the extraction sites. So you want to just use it kind of on the roof of your mouth area or around the edges of the denture. You really don't want a lot of adhesive going into the fresh extraction site. If you do, no big deal. It's not going to cause too much of an issue, but it's just better to avoid if you can.
Okay. That feels actually really good.
Okay. All right.
It really does. Okay. So now what are we going to do next?
Okay. Now we'll do the lower. So kind of the same exact thing that we did before. At this point, because your water from the microwave has been out for a little while, I recommend that you reheat it, since we're really trying to reactivate the entire, the lower denture from scratch again. So you want to, when you're doing the denture from start, you really want to make sure that initial, heating, when we're trying to get the thermoplastic properties to kick in, we really want to make sure it's in that nice hot phase.
All right, I have a question maybe you can answer while this is happening. How do you compare these to a permanent denture?
With a traditional denture, you do get customization. So you do have every individual tooth is put in place directly by a dental lab, which is a reason why traditional dentures cost so much. You know, I mean, they are very labor intensive to do. Not only do you have to come in to see me as a dentist, you know, multiple visits to get dentures made, but it also involves a lot of time in a lab going back and forth to customize for you. So when you have a traditional denture, you're going to have a little bit more customization because the size of the teeth are going to be different for you and the occlusion, everything's going to be lined up exactly for you. Well, what we've done with Easy Denture, which is why we've been able to make it so affordable and also it happens so quickly for patients, is to make everything thermoplastic. That really does help our patients out. But ultimately, you know, material-wise, Easy Denture and a traditional denture are pretty much identical.
All right, now we have our water is back. Now we want to fit the lower denture.
Yes. And I could see you in the mirror there as well. So the camera angle's good there.
Okay.
Okay. So now you're going to take the lower denture, put it teeth down for 60 seconds in the boiling water. And I like how you do the spoon. That way you don't get a splash, which is great.
And now we just wait.
And then you want to keep the upper denture in because you're trying to line up the bite of the upper denture. Now, if you already have an upper denture, for patients that already have an existing upper denture and they're getting just a lower Easy Denture or vice versa, or they have their natural upper teeth or natural lower teeth and you're sizing the Easy Denture against it, then you're just initially, when you put it in, you're trying to line up the bite, how the upper teeth and lower teeth come together as well. You're trying to line up that occlusion and just get it as comfortable as you can where the teeth really come together and meet. And then you adapt around the gums. And with the lower, Michelle, when the lower is in there, you'll feel it, how it kind of wants to hug your ridge, and then you'll go down and you'll squeeze all around to extend the material down through your vestibule and through your ridge to get it to hug in there.
And I have found that you want your flanges, the sides of your denture, you really want them to go down because that's what's going to hold the denture in.
Yes, it holds the denture in and also prevents food from getting underneath it. significant. Now, if your extensions are too long, that can cause a denture to kind of dislodge when you're eating. So if you find that it's too long, that's fine. Heat it again and just kind of trim those areas back or push those areas back. That's looking pretty good there, Michelle. What do you think?
I'm thinking I'll take it out. Same thing as before. Just take it out and set it down.
Take it out, set it down, teeth down. Now, are you using paper towels there?
Yes.
Okay, so paper towels are okay. I like a plate for it because I find that sometimes the stretch material gets a little sticky and will tear up a paper towel.
Okay, let's put it on the plate then if I can.
All right.
Sure can. I can see what you mean. It's a little sticky and okay.
Because if it grabs a paper towel, and that's fine, just kind of pull the pieces of paper towel off. It's the beauty of Easy Denture. You really can't mess it up. You know, if it doesn't fit right, put it in hot water and do it again. If you took too much material off, put it in hot water and add the material back.
I think this feels okay.
Okay, that looks good there?
Yeah.
All right, so now we're going to go and basically size the lower. So you want to put the lower in. We're trying to line up the bite if we can.
Okay.
Uh-huh. Line up the occlusion first.
Okay.
And you can do that because the denture goes this way, this way, this way, this way. You can adjust it multiple ways.
Okay, I think I got it.
Okay.
Can you see it?
It does look pretty good. You might want to pull the arch out a little bit more from the molar area and spread it out.
I don't think I understood that.
Okay, so kind of grab the molars and go outward with them.
Oh, okay.
Okay, to widen the arch a little bit. Okay, let me see that.
Should I bite down?
Yes, bite down gently. Okay, and then now just kind of spread here. Right around the gums. Get that to go down. And then run your fingers around the inside. Make sure you can lift up your tongue and it's not impinging on your tongue area as you're holding it down. And just try to extend those vestibules as much as possible.
I think it's okay.
Okay.
Let me look. I got it real close.
Okay.
What do you think?
It is really close. It's great for the first time, but you can see that the back teeth are kind of missing in the occlusion, aren't hitting where the uppers are.
Uh-huh.
So you want to heat that again.
Okay.
Just kind of spread the arch out a little bit more in the back.
Okay. Let me go heat my water up again.
And then you could actually probably drop it back in the water that's right there right now.
Okay.
Because you don't need to do a full reset, but probably just drop it in there for about 30 seconds.
Okay.
And then this time when we take it out, before you put it in your mouth, just kind of widen the arch a little bit more.
Let me show you. I just took this back out.
All right. So now you'll want to grab it and just kind of from the teeth side and just spread the arch a little bit. From the molars, grab the molars. There you go, a little bit like that, perfect.
Okay, now put it back in?
Now put it back in. And see if that arch lines up a little better.
I think so. Look.
Good, that lined up better in the back.
Oh, I can talk. Big difference.
And then you can do that as many times as you want to line up the bite just right. You know, that's real simple to do. I know we're taking a quick video here, but look, you got the upper really close in one try. You know, you had to cut back the extension in the back. You got the lower lining up pretty good. I mean, realistically, what would you say, less than 15 minutes?
Mm-hmm.
You've got teeth.
I have teeth now.
You have teeth.
I'm not gagging right now. I'm going to use adhesive to hold this in, yes. And that'll help me a lot from gagging.
And then just play with it. If you, after wearing it for a day, you're like, hey, this spot's hitting a little high. This is bothering me here. Put this spot in hot water, similar to what we did with the top where you had that extension in the back and you trimmed that area back.
Mm-hmm.
You could do that. You could spot, you know, you could do little spots and just put that in the hot water and trim those areas off until it's comfortable for you. Yes. You can take it out now and show how that adapted. Nice. And then, you know, we have and you know, those areas are really extended nicely down around the gum line. If that's too long for you, you could trim those areas back.
Even back here, if somebody needs to trim, they can trim this too.
Yes, they could trim all that back. And then once you put that under cold water, you'll see it turns back to the same color, because right now it's still in a soft phase.
I'm going to put some adhesive on the bottom of this.
Okay.
I'm a big fan of adhesive, even in my permanent denture. It's yes. A personal choice a lot of the time. And
I still think it's great. If you had the best fitting denture in the world, I still think adhesive just helps with the micro movement and get some seals in there to keep some food from getting underneath there.
How did I do?
You have teeth. You have teeth.
I have teeth.
Just like that.
So even if there's a problem, you can heat it back up and just take care of it that way.
That's right. Don't
cut anything off or mold anything again. I know I did a video once where they were just kind of out too far this way, mm-hmm. and I heated the front up a little bit and just kind of pushed them flat on my countertop down this way.
And you can do that when it's heated. Now, if it's not heated, you don't want to try to flex the teeth. Right. You're going to break, you'll break this like you can a traditional denture. You don't ever want to do
that. Right. I put it the front end back in the water like it did the back end.
Okay. Good, good.
Hold on. I can tell.
Those extensions on the bottom are pretty long in the back there.
Yeah. So I'm going to stick these just back in water while we're talking and just yes. cut those off.
Okay.
Because I know.
And then just trim those spots back. That did look a little long for the bottom there. But, you know, overall, time-wise, I mean, this was – you made it look very easy because it is that easy.
Basically, all it is practice. And you have yes. time to practice because you can keep reforming this.
And that's the thing. You know, you don't ever want anyone to get frustrated and say, oh, I can't do this. I can't do this. It didn't fit the first time. Hey, just relax. You know, put it back in hot water. And
I'm
do it again.
Cut some of this off.
Yes.
And even if I cut too much,
you can heat that again. So if you cut too much off, then you get it back to the boiling phase. And then you can heat it again. That water may have cooled a little bit. But.
Yeah, I think it did just a little bit. So, but I think that will be better for me.
Absolutely. Because that looked like a long extension there.
Oh, yeah, that's much better.
Okay, because those are the spots that will trigger your gag reflex, like down there on the bottom.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. This is good. I mean, it goes down.
Right. And if you want that further, you can do it. You know, heat it and go further. If you want it, if you don't want it to go down as far, you could heat it again and kind of pull your lip up and make sure that it's not getting any of the extensions. I really like how the Easy Denture adapts around those frenum attachments, those muscle attachments that you have in your mouth. Whenever it's warm, you want to pull those spots down. You want to adapt around it. It does a nice job.
All right. Well, there you go. Now you see how easy this is to fit. It really is easy. And once I get adhesive on this bottom, I'll quit.
Whittling. and that's it. You know, with our customer service team, we really just want you call up. We have it set up where you send us an email, we'll arrange a time where we could call you. And then, you know, we call you up and walk you through the process. We just want this to be successful for as many people as possible. You know, just really help bring more smiles to the world and make it easy, you know. And Michelle, as you know, life with dentures, you know, it's something, it's a great backup denture if you ever needed one. It's a great immediate denture. It could work as a permanent denture for patients that really are looking for that economic price point when it comes to dentures and can't get dentures made at their dentist or through other channels.
Right.
I know Denture Box makes a great, great denture. But those are more, a more expensive product. It does take time. It's more of a it's a custom denture. So there's great products out there to help people smile more. That's ultimately what it comes down to. Me being a dental implant, I'm an implant dentist. You know, I think there's nothing better than implants, you know, when it comes to that. But that comes at a whole different price point as well. We're looking at almost $60,000 when I do a mouthful of implants on a patient.
Yeah, well, that's crazy expensive. This is an affordable option, and I'm going to leave a link, my top link you'll see. If you click on that and go see, you can see what the pricing is. All right, Dr. Otero, thank you very much for helping me fit my denture.
Michelle, thanks for the time today. I hope you have a great week.
I hope you do too.
And if any questions, just feel free to call, okay?
All right, thank you.
All right, thank you. Bye-bye.
Bye, everybody.